Good morning students, this is Padmavati Indargi, Assistant Professor of Management from Government First Grade College, Devanahalli. Today I am going to talk on the topic Risk Analysis and Investment Decisions of Session 2 of Advanced Financial Management subject. Let us see what is the risk analysis, sources of risk, types of risk, difference between systematic risk and non-systematic risk. Here you will be able to define what is risk analysis, identify the sources of risk, what are the different types of risk, and difference between systematic and non-systematic risk. Let's have a quick recap of previous session. In previous session, I had dealt with the concept of risk and uncertainty. What is the difference is between the risk and uncertainty? And what are the different causes of risk? Here, risk means where we can assign some probabilities to the future outcome based on historical data. But in case of uncertainty, we are unable to forecast the future because uncertainty means which we are unknown of it. Either it might occur or it might not occur, but we don't know what is the future. And the causes of risk are varying, like political risk, legal risk, market risk, its competitors risk, interest rate risk, or the product demand risk. So there are various causes responsible for the risk to occur in the investment. Let's have a insight on the risk analysis. Risk analysis is the process of estimating the likelihood of occurrence of an adverse event. Because risk means adverse, it is unfavorable. Where in risk analysis, we are using some statistical techniques and tools to estimate what is the exact cash flow, giving some space for the risk. It is the study of underlying uncertainty of a given course of action and refers to uncertainty of forecasted cash flow streams, the variance, the standard deviation of portfolio, the probability of project success or failure. It is used to minimize the entire exercise. What we are doing in risk analysis is to minimize the future negative unforeseen effects. So what are the sources of risk? It might be a project specific risk. This is a risk which is related to the particular project. It arises due to the estimation of errors. The errors what we undertake in estimating the earnings of the project, or some factors that are specific to the project itself, like quality of management, some fault decisions taken in the project, overestimation of the cash flows. It is called as project specific risk. Next is company specific risk. Company specific risk, in a sense, this is a risk which is related to a particular company. If your company is very technologically technological oriented company, sudden changes in a technology might affect the company's earnings, or it is due to the change in management, or it is due to the change in the market value of a company. It is related to the company, which also affects the project performance. Next is industry specific risk. Industry specific risk, in a sense, it is the firm's earnings and cash flows which are affected due to industry factors. Industry factors means what? A government regulations or government attitude to the particular industry, example steel industry, sugar industry, or consumer behavior towards the industry, or any technological developments which affect the industry. Next is market risk. Market risk means it is a systematic risk which we cannot avoid, where each and every company has to face these risks. It affects the earnings and cash flow of all projects due to unexpected changes in macroeconomic factors. Here I am stating the macroeconomic factors which affects the all companies, like GDP growth rate, interest rates, inflation or deflation, where each and every industry has to face the market risk, which we cannot avoid it. Next is competitors risk. It is a risk or unfavorable situation which is arising due to the competitors' actions. the competitor's policies, the competitor's marketing strategies, competitor's advertising strategies, any changes in competitor's policies which affect directly or indirectly our project. Next is risk due to economic conditions. Economic conditions in the sense a sudden change in the economy, a sudden change in the marketing behavior in the economy, a sudden changes in the interest rate, sudden changes in the government policies, anything which can be measured economically is economic conditions. Next is international risk. It is a risk which arises only in case of international projects, in the sense if your project is international, it is affected due to some international policies, then the risk is called international risk, where it is affected due to unexpected exchange rate risk or any political risk or political relation between our country and the different country in which your investment is operating, in which in your project is operating, is called international risk. Then what are the types of risk? Types of risk are classified into two types. One is systematic risk and another is unsystematic risk. Systematic risk. Systematic risk is also referred as non-diversifiable risk, or it is also called as market risk. As I told, market risk or systematic risk is available in the system itself. Nobody, no company can control the systematic risk, because this is a risk which affects all the companies, all the industries altogether. Systematic risk is the fluctuations in return or securities that occur due to macroeconomic factors. Macroeconomic factors in the sense a large scale. On a large scale which affects the entire economy is stated as systematic risk. All industries are on equal footing. They have to face this systematic risk. Example, I can state Great Recession of 2008, where in the big banking industries have collapsed. It has brought an unemployment situation for all the countries, where it is operated on a macro level. Great Recession of 2008, where the housing loan, housing mortgage loans, it is because of the failure in giving a credit, wrong credit policy of the bankings, which made the big banks to collapse, and it led to the unemployment situation not only in foreign countries but also in India. We have faced many banks have faced the losses, many people have lost the job, that is, which has operated on a large scale on a macro level, the Great Recession of 2008. Next, the types of systematic risk. Systematic risks are further classified as interest rate risk, market risk, purchasing power risk. Interest rate risk refers to change in interest rates of banks, change in interest rates of bonds, change in interest rates of debentures. These all directly or indirectly affects the company's projects. Market risk means it is change due to the marketing forces, change in demand, change in supply policies, change in the GDP growth rate, change in the government regulations, change in the government budget. These all comes under marketing risk. Purchasing power risk refers to the value of money. It is the increasing trend of the prices, increasing prices, and also the value of the money comes down, the purchasing power of the consumer will come down. So this is purchasing power risk. Then in unsystematic risk, it is refers to a fluctuations in returns of a company arising due to microeconomic factors. Here microeconomic factors means it is related to the particular company. If your company is a steel, like for example Infosys company, TCS company, the risk which is associated only to the Infosys company, only to the TCS company, only to the Adani Steels. So that risk is called unsystematic risk. This risk factors exist within the company and can be avoided if necessary action is taken. Can be avoided in the sense if there is a sound management, if you are good at forecasting, if you can manage the risk very efficiently, then we can control this unsystematic risk. The risk factors can include the production of undesirable products, means the products which are produced without undertaking a good marketing study, or it is due to labor stress, gera, whose absenteeism of the labor, due to the inefficiency in the management decisions, due to the bad relations between the management and labor. So this is unsystematic risk. Types of unsystematic risk are financial risk, where faulty in taking financial decisions regarding equity or debentures, anything which is related to raising of finance, any faults in raising of finance, like cost of capital, faulty decisions in raising the debentures or raising the equity shares, any capital management, finance management risk is called financial risk. Business risk is related to the product failure, bad marketing strategies. Business risk andre ಒಂದು ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಬರುವಂಥ ರಿಸ್ಕ್, ಲೈಕ್ ಮಾರ್ಕೆಟಿಂಗ್ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಇರ್ಬೋದು, ಅಡ್ವರ್ಟೈಸಿಂಗ್ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಇರ್ಬೋದು, ನಮ್ಮ ಸೇಲ್ಸ್ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಇರ್ಬೋದು, ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ಸಿಗೆ ಅನ್ವಯಿಸುವಂಥ ರಿಸ್ಕನ್ನು ನಾವು ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ರಿಸ್ಕ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮೆಟಿಕ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅನ್ಸಿಸ್ಟಮೆಟಿಕ್ ರಿಸ್ಕ್? ರಿಸ್ಕ್ ಅಸೋಸಿಯೇಟೆಡ್ ವಿತ್ ದಿ ಮಾರ್ಕೆಟ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಅ ಹೋಲ್, ರಿಸ್ಕ್ ಅಸೋಸಿಯೇಟೆಡ್ ವಿತ್ ದಿ ಮಾರ್ಕೆಟ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಅ ಹೋಲ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮೆಟಿಕ್ ರಿಸ್ಕ್. ವೆರ್ ಆಸ್ ಅನ್ಸಿಸ್ಟಮೆಟಿಕ್ ರಿಸ್ಕ್ ಈಸ್ it is related to the particular industry or company. Systematic risk is uncontrollable, where unsystematic risk we can control. It is related to external factors. Unsystematic is related to internal factors, interest rate risk, market risk, purchasing power risk are the types of systematic risk. Financial risk, business risk falls under this category. Beta is the measure of systematic risk. Beta is the measure, we are measuring the systematic risk by the beta component. A residential variance is the measure of unsystematic risk. So thank you students, this is of session